Happy Easter. I'm Father Owen Burns from St. Mark's Parish in Christensis. And this morning I'm joined by
Tricia. I'm the catechetical coordinator here at St. Mark's.
And this morning we have an amazing recipe for you. But before we get to that recipe, let's recap what we've experienced during the Triduum during Holy Week. So on Thursday, we had an opportunity to enter into the Lord's Supper, the Last Supper. So we got to experience the Eucharist and the institution of the Eucharist, where Jesus gave us Eucharist for the very first time. On Good Friday, Tricia, do you remember what we did on Good Friday?
Yes, Good Friday is a solemn day because that is the day that Jesus is crucified on the cross. And here at St. Mark's, we have a service. It's not actually a Mass. And we sit and we reflect on Jesus' crucifixion and how he died for our sins.
And Holy Saturday morning is very quiet in the parish and usually quiet throughout the entire world until the Easter Vigil, where we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, where he's raised from the dead and the tomb is empty. And what better way for us to celebrate and make a very specific recipe than make resurrection rolls? So today we're going to start out by reading from the Gospel to hear what Jesus' disciples actually did to prepare his body for the grave. This is from the Gospel of John, chapter 19, verses 38 through 42. After these things, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, though a secret one, because of his fear of the Jews, asked Pilate to let him take away the body of Jesus. Pilate gave him permission, so he came and removed his body. Nicodemus, who had at first come to Jesus by night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. They took the body of Jesus and wrapped it with the spices in linen cloths, according to the burial custom of the Jews. Now there was a garden in the place where he was crucified, and in the garden there was a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. And so because it was a Jewish day of preparation, and the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there. There's something very interesting about that gospel passage, is that we hear about Jesus being wrapped in linen cloths, and it reminds me immediately of Jesus being born, and what did his mom do?
She wrapped him in swaddling clothes.
So when we hear about Jesus' birth at Christmas, it's actually telling us what's going to happen in Jesus' future. And there's another reference in this gospel about spice, about myrrh. And we were told again, when the wise men came to visit Jesus, they brought three gifts. Do you remember the gifts, Tricia?
Gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
So the wise men brought myrrh when Jesus was born, again, to point to the future, to point to today, to Jesus' death and resurrection when his body was prepared for the grave. So I'd say we jump in and start with our recipe.
Okay.
So again, we're making resurrection rolls today. So we're going to start out by opening our can or our tin of these crescent rolls. So it saves us a lot of time, and you just have to have the refrigerator ready to go. It's a bit of faith when you open these because they pop, right? So we don't want them to explode everywhere. All right, you ready for this?
Yes, I am.
Attempt two, there we go. So if you're doing this with your family, with your friends, there are 8 separate little triangles on this roll. So I'm gonna do, Tricia, I'm gonna give you 4 and I'll take 4.
Okay.
And we can work as a team.
Okay.
So you just have to unroll them, separate each individual triangle. Tricia has done this before. She's much quicker than I am. So Tricia, have you ever made these resurrection rolls before?
This is my first exposure to resurrection rolls, and I'm really excited about it.
All right.
I think it's a great family activity, and I think it's really doable for a lot of us at home, even with small children. So I think it's great.
So we also have some more ingredients lined up for us. So in a bowl, we have some white sugar, just regular white sugar. And Tricia is going to add some cinnamon to it. Now, we're not really going by any kind of measurements. If you want to use more or less, depending on the flavor that you're looking for, feel free to do so.
I think I made this a little bit spicy, but I think it will be fine.
And one thing that I'm noticing about the cinnamon is there's a great smell to the cinnamon. And I'm quite sure when Jesus' body was anointed with that myrrh that his disciples could also have a strong smell of spice, of that myrrh, to bring them back to that memory. So we also have some melted butter or margarine, depending on what you would like to use, in a separate bowl. And then we have marshmallows. So we know that Jesus is sinless, that he's pure, that there's a great sweetness about him. So we're going to use a marshmallow to represent Jesus. So Tricia, I'm going to give you a marshmallow. And just like the disciples, after Jesus' body was taken down from the cross, I'm going to ask you to anoint Jesus' body with some oil, right?
Okay.
And then when we're done that, we're going to take the marshmallow from the oil and put it into that sugar and cinnamon to the spice. And I'll do the same. Thank you. Taking a little bit longer. So we spoke about Jesus' body being wrapped in linen cloth after he was taken down from the cross. We also spoke about Jesus being wrapped or swaddled in cloth by his mom. So what do you think the next step is going to be, Tricia?
I think we're going to wrap him in cloth.
All right, so let's take one of our triangular pieces of dough, place the marshmallow covered in sugar and cinnamon toward the back of the triangle, and we're gonna roll it up. And it might be easier to do on the counter, I'm just gonna lift it up to show you. Just make sure that everything is sealed up nice and tight, right? So we're gonna wrap it up, make sure there's no seams, you can pinch them together. If you are a true baker, you might wanna do this a little bit differently, but I'm an amateur, so we're gonna do it the best that we can do on this side. So keep on wrapping it up. Make sure all the edges are all pinched together.
I'm just gonna grease this.
So depending on what kind of pan you have, if you have a muffin pan, you might want to grease the muffin pan. If you just have a flat pan at home and you want to put a piece of parchment paper down, you can do that as well. Just make sure all the seams are pinched nice and tight. All right. So I have one finished.
And I have one finished.
All right. So we'll place the marshmallow wrapped in butter or margarine. Again, wrapped in sugar and cinnamon. Wrapped in the cloth and the pastry. And we're going to put this into the muffin tin. And we're going to finish up doing our other three each. And we'll be right back to you. Welcome back. Tricia and I have completed wrapping each one of the marshmallows dipped in butter and margarine and then into sugar and cinnamon, wrapping the marshmallow and its mixture inside of a piece of pastry. So again, we're looking at the marshmallow as Jesus' body being anointed with oil and spice and then wrapped in that linen cloth. So if we remember what happened in the gospel, we know that Jesus' body was prepared for death and laid in that new tomb. So I'm gonna actually take the pan of resurrection rolls and put them in the oven, which is gonna be our tomb for this recipe. And like Jesus' disciples, we're asked to wait. So it's gonna take about 10, 12 minutes for the resurrection rolls to actually finish baking. And while we're waiting for those resurrection rolls to finish baking, let us go back to the Gospel of John and hear about Jesus' resurrection, hear about Easter Sunday morning. So we're going to continue where we left off, but this time we're looking at chapter 20. So we finished chapter 19 with the burial of Jesus, and we're going to go into chapter 20. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they had laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. Easter Sunday morning, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. And as we heard in the gospel account, when the disciples went to the tomb, Tricia, what did they find?
They found the cloth, the shroud that was left, and it was laying there. And as you said, the one from his head was laying nice and neatly folded. And that's all that was left.
So we know as Christians, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Alleluia. So the disciples, when they went to the tomb Easter Sunday morning, all they found were the linens that they used to wrap Jesus' body. The tomb itself was empty. Jesus was gone. He had been resurrected from the dead. All right, I think I smell something very, very sweet and good coming from the oven. So I'm just gonna go check on our resurrection rolls. So if you're working with an adult, which you should be, you shouldn't be using the oven unsupervised. The pan is extremely hot. And let's see what they look like when they come out. All right, so make sure you have an adult help you with this part. Even adults, if you're doing this, be very, very careful because there is very, very hot sugar all around these resurrection rolls and on the pan, and hot sugar can burn us very easily. So what do you think, Tricia? Should we take them out and see what happens?
Yes, we should, but we should wait a moment first.
All right, let's wait another moment. We'll be patient, just like we were patient while the resurrection rolls were in the oven, in the tomb. So after letting the resurrection rolls cool down just for a little bit, we've taken most of them out, but I'll ask Tricia to take out the last one and let you see what they look like. So that is the resurrection rolls utterly complete. But as we heard in the gospel, the disciples didn't just wrap Jesus' body in spice and linen and lay in the tomb and walk away and never come back, right? We heard in the gospel that on Easter Sunday morning, today, they returned to the tomb. And Tricia, what did they discover in the tomb?
The stone that was there was rolled away, and there all that was left was the linen cloth. And there was the cloth that had been around his head was laying folded neatly, and that was all that was left.
So when the disciples returned to the tomb Easter Sunday morning, they found the tomb completely empty. So if we're making resurrection rolls, what do you think is going to be inside the resurrection roll?
I'm hoping and thinking that nothing is going to be in there because Jesus has left the tomb.
So let's take a look inside. I cut this one up just before turning the cameras back on. All right, so we're gonna open it up. And inside, Tricia?
Nothing.
The tomb is empty. Jesus is risen from the dead. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Well, I think we've done a great job making our resurrection rolls today. That's going to be it for us. But Tricia, what was your favorite part of making the resurrection rolls today?
I think just learning about this recipe is just great. I think it's great for kids. I think it's great for families. And it's a great way to connect something you do in the kitchen to the Word of God. And I think it's great and it's wonderful for families. Great way to celebrate Easter.
We're going to be posting this video on our YouTube account as well as our Facebook account for the parish, for St. Mark's Parish. If you have access to our Facebook account or if your parents have access to the Facebook account and you end up making these resurrection rolls, I'm going to ask you to comment in the comment section. And if you can, take a photo of the finished product and how much fun you had making them. If they turn out like the batch that Tricia and I made, that's amazing. Post that photo. And if your batch looks more like my first attempt, it's okay. You can post that photo as well because I posted my photo. We just want to see how much fun you've had doing the resurrection rolls and also learning about Jesus' death and resurrection. So from St. Mark's Parish, Happy Easter.
Happy Easter. Alleluia.